Welcomes you all in this session. To our respected Shekhar sir and our chief guest, Ms. Preeti. Ms. Preeti is an assistant primary coordinator at CP Goenka International School at Thane. She has a qualification of MCOM, B.Ed. Diploma in Early Childhood Education, Postgraduate Diploma in Psychotherapy and Counseling, Diploma in HR from Willinker Institute, MSc, and currently she is pursuing Postgraduate Diploma in School Leadership and Management from IGNOU. She has other qualification which she has participated in Oxford and Cambridge workshop. She has been teaching since last 18 years, and she has trained till now around 3,500 students. It's a pleasure to hear you, ma'am. We welcome you again. The platform is yours.
Thank you, Poonam. Thank you for such a wonderful introduction. And good afternoon to all of you. Everyone is MBA students? All are MBA students here? Or do we have some other crowd as well? I guess everybody is on mute.
Yeah, mainly everyone is MBA except me.
Okay, fine. So shall we start? As all of you know, we are here to listen about how to empower our students for 21st century schools, for 21st century skills. Shall we start then?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Can you see my screen? Can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
So all of us are here to learn 21st century skills. Before starting, I would let us keep this as an interactive session. How many of you are aware, like, what are 21st century skills actually? Would somebody like to answer? Or is everybody here to listen?
Can you repeat?
Yeah, I am asking, what are 21st century skills actually? Why are we here? What is that you have in your mind, that what will you get to learn after today's session?
Ma'am, I want to try, like, I'm not sure about it.
Yeah.
If in 21st century, we should be more technical, we should be more active in the, active in social medias where each and everything is happening, like these are posted in these things.
Right, very good. I always keep on saying that like we have been born in 19th century, but you children are lucky, you have been born in 20th century. So the page on the calendar, it is not just that the page has changed, but actually it has come from 1999 to 2000, that is to 21st century. First of all, let us see what were the changes, what was the technology before and how does it look now. How many of you have seen these types of gramophone, other than museum, have you seen these somewhere? Or you have not seen also in the museum?
No, ma'am, I have not seen.
These type of old phones, it has been replaced by mobile phones now. We had these type of printers, but now our printers are obviously much more advanced. Methods of payment have changed. Everybody uses e-cards now. The education has changed. We had typewriter, but everybody has laptops and their tabs now. Now today's learners are different. Most of the times, how many times like your parents tell you something and you do it without asking them anything, without questioning them anything? Nowadays, generation has changed completely. They think and process the information fundamentally differently from their predecessors. Like your way of thinking is different, our way of thinking is different. And now we will learn why that thinking way has been changed and what further you should do for that. Why are 21st century skills important is because today's education faces irrelevance. Unless we as educators, we bridge the gap between how students live and how students learn, only then you will be able to apply to the 21st century skills. It is through these 21st century skills that our young adults will find the power to be globally competitive in the worldwide workforce and find the ability to face career challenges in an ever-changing world of technology. What are the career challenges that you must be facing right now? If you can name a few, anybody?
Ma'am, I think career challenges which we are facing right now is many companies are being digital. So nice. The productivity somewhere is double because they are saving their time of traveling. And in this way, they don't require more manpower.
Okay, but all these are technology problems. Yeah. Besides that, as a human being, what all qualities should be there in a human being to adapt to these 21st century skills? Now, the fundamental four C's of 21st century skills are collaboration, communication, creativity, and critical thinking. This you will not get from any of the technologies. This you have to develop in yourself. How many of you know what is collaboration about? Is only shaking hands called collaboration? Okay, the people, the group, the team of 50 people working in a company is called collaboration. What is collaboration all about? You must have studied something in your MBA. One example of collaboration. Actually, collaboration occurs when two or more people work together to accomplish a common goal, teaming up to meet their defined goal. Most of the times what happens is in a company, all the team members are asked to do something. They are informed what is to be done. What is informed? When? For example, on 15th of October 2020. How? We will be doing this. But are the team members informed that why are they doing certain thing? Unless you don't share your goal with your team members, they will not be able to work in collaboration. You are not going to get the desired results. So the most important thing is sharing the why of any and everything that you're doing. Only then your team members and you will be working in collaboration towards the shared goal. How will you be working into this collaborative abilities is you have to allocate resources and responsibilities so that all the resources are used optimally. Not that ye mere department ka resource hai, this cannot be used in that department or something like that. You have to sit collaboratively, brainstorm upon the ideas and reach on to a mutual goal, reach on to a mutual decision with everybody's consensus. And then decision making has to be very strong while this collaboration is happening in the team. You require sorting through many options actually basically provided to the group and arriving at a single option to move forward. There will be difference of opinions for sure. But then again, argument should not happen. Rather than there should be decision making, discussion making to reach on to a decision. And delegation of work is very, very important. It is not that as a team leader, you have to be on doing the entire work, whereas you should be delegating your work so that only then you will be like reaching to your goal much more faster. That is called collaboration. When you are using the resources together, when you brainstorm the ideas, it is not that always the team leader has to come and he has to impose his decision on his team that you will be doing this. Rather than that, you have to brainstorm on the ideas and make a decision collaboratively, delegate work among them, among yourselves. Only then you will be able to reach to your goal. Evaluating the products, processes, and members of the group. There are different type of as in we have people with different behavior, with different nature, but then it is as a team leader, you have to decide like how to evaluate the people working with you, the members of the group. How will you set the goal of your group and how are you going to lead the group? How are you going to contribute to towards the group? Then again, you also have to teach your team members, that is managing time. Managing time is very, very important. Most importantly nowadays, especially when everybody is working online, managing time has become very difficult. But you as a team leader should be showing them the path, how should they manage their time so that the conflicts are resolved in the bud itself. You have to nip it in the bud. And then team building means cooperatively working overtime to achieve a common goal. After collaboration comes on to communication. Now, what is communication? Just talking over the phones on WhatsApp, is that called communication? Is what? Where does communication come from? How do we talk? Okay. Can you read the colors now as fast as you can? Now, all of you have to answer for this. If you can read the colors here.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, can you read the colors here?
Green, red, black, yellow, green, blue, yellow, black, red, blue.
Very good. Now I will show you one more slide. Now here, you don't have to read the words, but you have to read the colors in which these words are written. How will you read it?
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah.
Green,
right.
White, purple, pink, black, orange, blue, red, yellow, red, blue.
Yeah. Why did we do this exercise and the previous one? Here, did you think anything before talking? Before saying the colors? Did this picture make you think?
No, ma'am.
And did this picture make you think?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is what is important. As if you also go physically, if you look at your body physically, our head is before our mouth. So that means you need to think before you speak. You need to think twice before you speak. You need to think while you speak. You need to think after you speak. 21st century skills are think before you speak, think before you communicate, think before you speak, think while you speak, and also think after you speak. Always, you should not just speak out things randomly. You should do your research first. You should be able to communicate for your team so that your team reaches to the goal faster and at the given time. Now, communication, again, if we go to this slide, again, this also means as your communication, your talking skills needs to have clarity in what you're talking. Expressing your thoughts should be clear. It should be crisp, not that you're talking for hours and hours and the person at the other side is just not interested in listening what you're saying. So you should be crisp. Your thoughts should be clear. Your opinion should be articulated. Now, what does articulation mean here in your opinion? What does articulation mean here is that you should sequence your thoughts so that the person at the other side should also understand what are you trying to say and why are we listening to this. At the same time, your communication should be such that it motivates the other people. Your speech should be powerful. Your speech should be impactful. These skills have always been valued in the workplace and in the public life. How many of you have felt that I am just talking and nobody is listening to me? Have you ever felt that in your college or at your workplace if you are joined somewhere? You will feel this only if your talk is not impactful. So that is why I am saying is your talk should be clear, crisp and well articulated. Now, how will you do that? You have to analyze the situation. But and secondly, you have to choose a medium of talking in which everybody understands. Not that you are talking in a language which nobody understands. Now, language is not only English, Marathi, Hindi, but also a polite language. A way of talking it also comes under communication. You have to evaluate your messages, whether are you sending complete messages or incomplete, or there is ambiguity in your messages. You have to make that clear first before starting the communication. And then you also have to follow your conventions. You have to listen to everybody in the team. Reading is decoding written words and images in order to understand what their originator is trying to communicate. When you're communicating, obviously you will be trying to listen to the other person as well. So you have to also understand and to listen what the other person is trying to say. You have to speak in a tone of voice, in a body language, gestures, facial expressions and visual aids in order to convey your ideas perfectly. And then you also have to give the other people turn to speak. Using technology, as somebody in the beginning was saying, 21st century skills is about learning how to use technology, but there is also requires understanding the abilities and the limitations of any technological communication, from phone calls to emails to instant messages. How many of you like answer the, I know all of you must be answering to WhatsApp, to Instagram, to Facebook instantly, but do you answer to your emails instantly? at least what is your reverge time? Is it 1 hour, 2 hours, 6 hours, or 24 hours? The ideal time should be like, you should not extend to beyond 24 hours to answer an email. You should always see that you answer your email within 24 hours, how much ever busy you are. Otherwise, your communication will be of no use. Again, writing involves encoding messages into words, sentences, and paragraphs for the purpose of communicating. Whenever you are talking, you should see to it that you are writing each and everything to whatever the discussion is about, so that when you go back, you can also always refer to this communication that you have written. Now, the importance of communication is to effectively analyze the process, the overwhelming amount of communicator in our lives today. Which information sources are accurate? You need to know that. Not that whatever you see on Google is true. You have to first analyze that whatever information sources are, whether are they accurate or not, and which ones are accurate, and how they can be used or leveraged effectively. To build communication skills, the students must communicate using digital media and environments to support personal and group learning. Not that you all are, while you all are learning, even in your college or at your workplace, you should be learning collaboratively and with effective communication. Sharing information effectively is very, very important. Only then you will be able to share thoughts, share your opinions with each other. Communicate thoughts and ideas clearly and effectively to different audiences using various media and formats. That is very, very important. Now, creativity. What does creativity mean to you? Just drawing something, is that creativity, or what is creativity according to you? Who would like to answer?
Ma'am, can I try?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, we can say that creativity means thinking out of box.
Very good. Very good. And what if I say, as per 21st century skills, think as if there is no box? You should give wings to your imagination. There should be endless creativity. There should be boundless imagination. I will show you one picture ahead that will explain what creativity is all about. Creativity is bringing into being of something which did not exist before. That means you have to think something new that the other person will buy your idea. Otherwise, why will he or she? Either as a product or a process or a thought. The other person needs to buy your idea only when you are creative, only when you are something different. That is what creativity is all about, to produce something new, diverse, and unique ideas. Thinking creatively means looking at things from a different perspective and not be restricted by rules, customs, or norms. That does not mean that you have to break all the rules of your workplace, but only thing is that you have to give imagination to your creativity, wings to your creativity. What can you see in this image? This will describe what creativity is all about. What can you see in this image? There are 9 people in this image. Can you see that? Can you locate that? All of you can see a man with a bald man and hair at the back. This female. Anything else that you can see? Can you see something here? An old man. This is his hat.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, if you see here, there is one more old man looking at the other side. Actually, you should be locating the pictures for me. There are how many people in this? I have already given the answer. There are 9 people in this. Can you see that creativity here? I have already described about 4 people. Can you locate 1 or 2 more? Okay, not a problem. Actually, this is the mantra. If you can't convince them, confuse them. And how will you confuse them? With your creativity. Only you and your creativity can confuse the other people, and then they will buy your idea because they need to understand further what are you talking about. In the previous image, there were 9 people in that picture. If you find 6, you have ordinary power of observation. If you find 7, you have above average power of observation. 8 means you're observant. Congratulate yourself. And 9 means you're extremely observant. Do you want me to go back again to that picture? Let us check. How much do you get? Now, would you like to judge? Would you like to get a 6, 7, 8 or 9? नहीं दिख रहा है कुछ. Only the ones that I said.
Ma'am, actually, yes, this girl is holding a baby in her arm.
Very good. Very good. Excellent. Who is this? Sakshi Priya?
Yeah, yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Very good, Sakshi. Very good. Excellent. Anybody else wants to try? This is the baby here. Anybody else? Not a problem. So, Sakshi, you can get 6 ordinary power of observation. Now, you need to go beyond that. You need to increase your, all of you here. You need to improve your observation skills so that it is not. Now, why this picture was inserted here is, it is not only what the person is trying to show you. You have to see beyond. Always you have to see beyond. You have to think beyond what is, whether the person, what it, he or she is trying to show you, is that the only information you should be seeing is what is important. I will always give a suggestion to you to 21st century, for 21st century, that trust before, I mean, verify before you trust. Always verify before you trust. Don't trust blindly. Don't just look at what the other people are trying to show you, but you should always think and see beyond is what is important. Now, main creative abilities are brainstorming ideas. You have to brainstorm the ideas among your team members, amongst your friends, and you have to create something in collaboration after communicating with each other. Design something that is new. Every time new kahan se lain. This is not the case. You can get new every time. Why not? When yesterday was different from today, tomorrow is going to be different from today. So you should also be getting new ideas every day, because there is a new day every day. So why not new ideas every day? Only then you will be able to sustain yourself in the job market. Now, entertaining others is not passing on jokes and passing on different comments, but whereas you should involve, when you're communicating with someone, you should involve them by sharing stories, sharing your experiences, making jokes and playing games. It is not that it always has to be a serious type of environment in your office. Now, imagining ideas. As I said, always think as if there is no box. You have to keep on imagining ideas. Improvise a solution. Everybody in your team member will definitely have some solution, but you always have to improve that solution in some other way by giving some innovative ideas or thoughts to it and overturning something. Means flipping it to get a new perspective. Always don't look from the same perspective, but think, see beyond so that you get different perspectives of the same thing. Problem solving is important as it requires using many of the creative abilities listed here to figure out possible solutions and putting one or more of them into action. Problem solving means mummy daddy ko kaise chupaye ki we have to use phone. This is not a problem that you have to be solving. And problem solving is actually how to reach on to your goal, how to make your company profit more better before you join the company, and after you joining the company, there should be a stark difference in it. You should be knowing how to solve the problems of your immediate boss. You should be questioning actively, as in if you're doing something, what is the goal? What is the purpose behind doing that? What is the logic behind doing that? Only when you are questioning, that means you're trying to learn something. So be alert, keep on questioning, and make your team members to question you that what are you doing? Why are we doing? And where will we be reaching out of this? An essential aspect of creativity is not being afraid to fail. None of you should ever think that what if I fail? It's okay. As they say, ships are safest at the harbor, but that is not the place to be. You need to be fearless so that only then you will get different type of perspectives and you will get wingless imagination. Critical thinking. Have you seen Filmfare Awards? People get the best critic award and all those things. What is critical thinking? Passing negative remarks for something is critical thinking. Looking at things negatively is critical thinking. Or what is critical thinking? Would anybody like to answer? Critical thinking basically is focused, careful analysis of something to better understand it. When people speak of left brain activity, they are usually referring to critical thinking. Critical thinking means looking at the other side of your goal, that if this thing does not happen, is my plan B ready? If plan B does not happen, is my plan C ready? Looking at things in a way that what if this solution does not work? What if this suggestion does not work? So you always have to keep on thinking critically to whatever you suggest to the other person. You always have to analyze the suggestions of the other person critically, that what if his suggestion or his idea does not work. You have to reason, be good at reasoning, evaluating, problem solving, decision making, and analyzing. First of all, you should always start with analyzing things. Don't just look at things. You need to go through the things, scan the things, start reasoning the things, question about things, evaluate the things. And then after evaluation, you will be at a stage where you will be able to solve the problems. Only then you will be good at your decision making. Now, critical thinking is investigating issues that are not always clearly defined. First of all, the issues will not be defined at all. Whether clearly or not clearly, it will not be defined at all. You need to think critically that what problems will you be facing if you are doing this particular thing in a particular way, or if you are doing this particular thing in another way. Always you have to think critically, you have to think beyond, and you need to get solutions to your own problems and of the problems in the team. Now, what are the common critical thinking abilities? Is again, as I said, analyzing, arguing, there will be difference of opinions in the team. You need to discuss among each other, classify things, compare and contrast. Is like pointing out the similarities and differences between two or more subjects. When two or more people are talking, at most of the times, your thinking may match with each other. At most of the times, it may not match. That does not mean that you have to leave the table and go away. But you should always compare and contrast, and you should always make your point of view understand to the other person. You should define the term, the denotations, the connotations and examples, the synonyms of why you are doing a certain thing. You should describe the traits of something, such as the size, the shape, the weight of your goal and your process of reaching the goal. Only then the other person will understand once you are clear in your communication. You need to evaluate, explain, solve the problems, and you have to track the cause and the effect both. As I said, you should be explaining cause, that is why of a certain thing. And as a team leader, you should have your focus at the goal, that is at the effect of certain things. Why you're doing this and what are you expecting as outcome out of this? Can you see here two eyes in the O's? Yes, Sakshi. I see Sakshi always answering every time. Yes, Sakshi.
Yeah, yes, ma'am. Actually, look,
so what does that mean? You have to always keep your eyes open, as in just as not to see but to see through. You have to see through and through the things. You have to analyze the skins, you have to scan the things, you have to forecast the things, you have to plan, and you see as in look. Here, as in always, keep a vision in your mind whenever you are working. You have to keep on looking ahead, looking beyond, rather than looking at the back. Today's citizens must be active critical thinkers if they are to compare evidence, evaluate competing claims, and make sensible decisions. In everyday work, employees must employ critical thinking to better serve customers. Now, here again, it says one needs to have critical thinking to serve customers. Why? Because we need to think as a customer what the customer will be liking, so that as a company you serve him exactly the same thing. Only then you will be able to develop better products and continuously improve yourself as a team, as a company, with an ever-changing global economy. You should shift your headspace from global connections and collaborations. Now, what is global collaboration? Is just connecting to a company out of India, somewhere in US, UK, that does not mean collaboration. You have to work in collaboration. Both the companies need to have a common goal and need to like have mutual consensus every time, so that you achieve the goals much more rationally. And you have to like critically think with all the curiosity and creativity. immerse yourself in the culture. Think across disciples, spaces, functions, and knowledge connections. How many of you have written on a slate? I guess nobody has born in this era of 1890s writing in a slate, whereas we all of us use tabs, laptops, all those things. So as the physical things have changed, where we used to write and now how are we writing, that means the mindset also has to be changed. So it is only you who can change yourself. By embracing change, and now change is the law of life. Here you have to keep on changing, you have to keep on adapting technologies and different ways of collaboration. Basically, as I started with this, the four C's are important. Now, who is going to tell me about those four C's? What were they? Sakshi, except you, anybody else? The four C's we started with.
Hello?
Yes.
Ma'am, the four C, yes ma'am. The yes. Four C's were collaboration, communication, creative thinking, and critical analysis, I guess.
Right. Very good. So it is bold, and what happens is speaking bold breaks the mold. You need to be bold in your communication. You need to be bold in your convincing powers. You need to be flexible. Notice that whatever you say is the last word, but you need to be flexible in your team. Be creative, challenging, and complex. This is how this 21st century learners learn nowadays, with earphones, listening to the music, computer working in front of them, and a book in front of them. Now, there are multiple literacies for 21st century. As you can see here, you should be good at art and creativity, eco-literacy, cyber literacy, physical fitness, globalization, emotional literacies, media literacy, and financial literacy. Now, it is not that you have done MBA in certain thing in finance or in HR, so that means you need to be good at only those things, but you need to be good at all these things if you want to sustain yourself in the 21st century. Now, these are digital age literacy. All of you are already good at digital thinking. Inventive thinking is important, wherein, again, you have to believe in yourself and believe in taking the risk. Because you should be sure about yourself that you will be able to make your team reach to the desired goals. How will that happen is, once you communicate effectively, you will definitely get high productivity. In today's seamless world, countries have greater understanding of how different systems of education functions. It is not that there is only one way of working on things, whereas there are different ways of working on things. The thing is the same, but only because people are different, so there has to be different ways of thinking as well, different ways of critically analyzing the things as well. Here, what should your mantra be is the three I's: investigate, innovate, and invent. How will you investigate? Only if you have critical thinking. How will you innovate? Only if you talk collaboratively with your team. Only then all of you together as a team will be able to invent something new, which will be accepted by your company and the company at the other side. There should be different dimensions of effective technology, enhanced learning environments. It should be task-oriented, challenging, collaborative, something constructivist to be coming out of it. Your team members should be responsive, you should be responsive, you should reflect to their thoughts, and everything should be informative discussion process to reach out to a decision process. How many of you know about this, that to start a discussion, you need to have data in your hand, you need to collect certain information on your data, then you need to discuss among your team on the knowledge of all the people that they have in your team, and only then you will be reaching out to a wisdom that will create a decision for your team. Are all of you having these skills mentioned here? All of you present here, do you have these skills mentioned here? How many of you are good at problem solving? How many of you are good at decision making, critical thinking? Do you have all these skills? Stress management, nowadays stress is very easily, it seeps in. I would like to say here is, stress comes only when you accumulate things in your head. You need to shed off certain things. You need to be focused. Whatever you're working at, you need to be focused only at that particular thing at a time. If your brain is thinking multiple things, you will definitely get into stress. So you need to speak out with your team so that you always delegate the work and there is no stress among the team members. This is the second last type. So whenever you work, work with 3H, and that is all, work with all of your heart, head, and hands. Anybody would like to ask something? I've already asked many questions, but very few were answering. Anybody has to ask anything? I leave the floor open for the questions. Poonam, does anybody has to ask something?
No, ma'am. I think there's no one who has asked question.
It was nice talking to you. I hardly could listen to any one of you. I could listen to only to Sakshi and to Poonam. That is it. Fine then. Thank you. You can anytime reach out to me through Poonam or through Shekhar.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for being with us. I would like to thank you on the behalf of whole Airco's Aviation Private Limited.
Thank you.
It was a nice session. Thank you.
Thank you.